Hey, hello guys, welcome back to another video. Today I'm gonna share with you the templates that I normally use on my Dribble account to post more often on Dribble. And these templates are gonna be in Adobe XD and these are gonna help you to improve how fast you do your templates on Dribble. You see, I teach you how to make your portfolio, but I did not share with you guys, and I'm sorry, how to improve your presence online as a designer by simply posting more. You gotta do small projects every day or once a week and try to keep growing your designs, because the best way to get better at design is designing. Without any more delay, let's just start designing. Okay guys, we're gonna open Adobe XD in this case, and you're gonna see when you download these files, you're gonna have this right here. I have alternative backgrounds and I have a website page post template, logo project template, email design template, and a different type of templates that you can use right here. It's a total of maybe 8 or 9. The first one is gonna be the landing page design post template. So in this particular one, I'm gonna use some of the images that I have right here. Give me 1 second. In the desktop, I have these images that I save right here. So they have images of an email and I have a website. So in this particular case, I'm just gonna try to drag this PNG on top of the template and it's gonna fit perfectly. And if I wanna just change the background, I'll take one of these alternative backgrounds and pressing option. I'm just gonna drag it to duplicate the background and I'm gonna align it and press command shift and back bracket just to send it to the back. And here we have our amazing website. But one thing that I normally like to do, this is a small tip, is that I like to put rounded corners to the design. And the best way to do that is I like to just do at least 10 and in each side, so 10 and 10. And we have a rounded corners right there in the website design. Here we have already a good post. A good thing to keep in mind is that the post for Dribble, I think the size is 1920 by 1440p. It's because the aspect ratio that Dribbles like to manage with their designs. In the case of the logo design project, I'm just gonna try to put a logo here just to replace it to show you guys how simple it is to do. You just simply need to go back to the file. I'm gonna try to go to Illustrator. This is one of the reasons why I like to work with Adobe XD, since I can, you know, share files from Adobe Illustrator to Adobe XD and it works so seamlessly. I just simply love it. I'm gonna take this rustic logo that I did and I'm gonna copy it. I'm gonna bring it to Adobe XD. I'm gonna just paste it. I'm gonna use it right here in the middle and I'm gonna try to make it. I'm gonna press command comma just to see right here. There we go. Where do we have the logo? I'm just gonna remove this. I'm gonna try to make the logo in dark. I'm just gonna make sure that I have the right colors. I'm just gonna copy the color from Adobe Illustrator, go back to Adobe XD, and then I'm just gonna replace the color. Oh, I'm gonna replace the color right here. I just double click that twice. Okay, and then we have the logo right here. One of the things that I would like to do as well is just to put the logo in the negative version right next to it. And I'm just gonna remove this right now. And I'm just gonna take this, put it right next to it. I'm gonna go back to my Adobe Illustrator file and I'm just gonna take this red color that I have right here, place the color right here. Okay, that looks really good. One thing that I would like to also try is not to repeat the logo twice. I have an alternative version of the logo right here. I'm just gonna take this and I'm gonna remove this logo. I'm gonna place this other one. I think it's gonna look better. Let me just copy this color right here and then use this small version of the logo right here. This is an alternative version of this logo. And one thing I also like to do is to, I'm gonna just duplicate this square right here just for the purpose of aligning this two. So I'm gonna try to, there we go, align it right there. We have this logo aligned here. I'm just gonna try to do the same with this one. So here we have the two versions of the logo. There is another version that I would like to also use. I have right here this. I'm just gonna try to use the simple, the R of the logo right here. I'm just gonna paste it right here. I'm gonna take it just for a second. I'm just gonna try to place it right here. As you can see, it's really simple. We just have to drag and drop different parts of the design. I'm just gonna try to use this different type of tone right here. I'm just gonna copy and paste this color. Okay, I'm just gonna, okay, it's a lighter color right there. And I'm gonna use this. This is like an off-white, like a creamy white right here. And I'm gonna just try to place it for the canvas. One thing that I would recommend for you guys is, since you get this file, you can also duplicate the artboards and keep working underneath the artboards, which is gonna help you a little bit as well. One thing I would also like to try to do with this design as well is to go back to the design and take this alternative version of the logo right here. I'm just gonna copy this. And one of the ways that I also did this logo, which is, I think is kind of cool, is that I took the font and I mask it like this. Let me show you guys. This is something I like to do sometimes. In this case, I just took, I'm gonna do it from Illustrator. So I just separate the logo. Okay. And I take this part, we remove this, take this completely. We go to Adobe XD, we remove this and then we just paste it. But the part that I like that I did was this, that I used the logo really big and you can kind of see the logo, but it gives you that type of a texture of the logo right like this. One thing I was doing, it was this. Okay, I have to do an Illustrator. I'm gonna take this part, okay? I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna select this part, Command X, and then Command V again. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna paste it, okay? And I'm gonna take and make it really, really big right here. Okay, I'm gonna take this Command Z, Command V, and then I'm gonna take this text. Okay, I'm gonna mask it with the shape. And in this case, what I like to do is I like to select the same color and just make it a little lighter. And we go back to Adobe Illustrator and I take this right here and I paste it in the middle. Okay, I align this to the middle of the composition right here and I just take it and I make it a little bigger, kind of like this, to give this alternative version of the logo. I normally like to also use the colors that I use in the actual project, which is this blue right here. I need to replace it here in this part. Just let me try to do that. So because I need to also put the logo in negative as well. So I'm gonna take this out of here. I'm gonna use this part of the logo. I'm gonna put this in the front. I'm just gonna, okay. I'm just gonna align this right here. You know, you're gonna have a better logo, better stuff than this, but this is just to show you guys how you can normally use this stuff. And the next step will be just to replace, you know, the colors that I use within this project. I'm just gonna start with the off-white, then the red, then the blue, and then this dark color that I use right here. And there we have it. So this is how we do a post for a logo design. In the case of the emails, you just need to make a email design. Normally, emails design have a specific size for them. I have an example right here of an abandoned card that I did. And this one is 1200 by any size you want. I think it's smaller. It's like 800 because of MailChimp or something. I think it's kind of like 800 for an email. 800, I'm talking about the width of the email. I'm gonna take this email, I'm gonna replace the one that I have in the template just to show you how simple it is. You simply take the email, you drop it on top, and then you just need to drag and align it. I'm pressing shift right now. Okay, it works perfectly. And I'm just gonna do the same thing with the other one. Just gonna drag and drop it, double click it, and align it from the bottom. As I told you guys before, there's multiple backgrounds that you can use right here. I'm gonna take this one right here, which is a lighter one that will give me better contrast with what I have right here. I'm just gonna send it all the way to the back, and I'm just gonna remove whatever I had right here, and it's gonna give me this new background for this one in particular. I'm gonna do another template to show you. This is the website full page template. It's gonna be as simple as I show you before, guys. We're gonna take one of the websites that I have right here. I'm just gonna drag and drop it on top. It aligns perfectly. I need to just shrink it a bit and try to fit the size of it. Just gonna make it a little bigger, but not too much. Just gonna bring it down a bit, okay? This is the same one with the other side. Take the website, we drag it on top. That's actually almost a perfect fit right there. We bring it the size a little bit down and we just bring the image down a little bit. We just move it a little bit to the size. And then here we have it. We're just gonna, you know, since it's dark on dark, it's not gonna look really well. So one thing I would like to try to do is simply going back to the backgrounds that I have and take one of the backgrounds and then replace it. You can also use your own colors for this as well. So I normally, you could also use these shadows that I have right here, but a good tip would be that you can use the, for example, I'm gonna use the green of the brand and put it in the background. And I'm just gonna align this within the back. I'm gonna change the blending mode to maybe overlay or maybe multiply. That could work as well. And then we're gonna have the shadows playing a little bit with the design, but also we're gonna have the website on top of it. And there's other options that I also include in this template, which is the mobile and desktop versions of the sites. And I also include some versions for light and dark mode. And here's a really good tip that you can also use, guys, is that when you're working on Dribble, a good hack that I like to do is to keep posting more designs. Just simply use, if you do a website, do the light mode in a post and the dark mode in another post. You're gonna have more shots and more chances to be discovered in the social media. I'm gonna try to take this and I'm gonna ungroup this. And I have this too. I'm just gonna try to have this one, this light website that I have right here, just for the light mode. I'm just gonna try to drop it on top. I'm gonna have this one, which is the mobile version of it. I'm just gonna drag it down, pressing shift right now, just dragging it down to align it. And it was as simple as that. So you make your website, you export it as a PNG. You can do it in any software you want. Normally I do them in Adobe XD. You export them and then you just drag and drop within the template. It's gonna work perfectly. Again, this is completely free, guys. I'm just doing this to help you guys to come up with more designs and get a better chance to get discovered on Dribble or anywhere where you like to post. Let's just make the last one. And this one is gonna be this array that I have for the website. And it's as well, really simple. I'm just gonna select this one in particular, and I'm just gonna drag and drop the mobile version that I have right here for this website. I'm just gonna drag and drop right there. Try to kind of align it real quickly. Okay, this version is gonna be kind of complicated because as you can see, it's a little smaller than the other one, but I think I can still do it. Okay, I just need to fit it within the bounds of the design. Okay, I'm trying to make it a little bigger without getting, okay, compressing shift right now and trying to align everything as good as possible. Okay. And here we have this part right here. And one trick I like to do is I like to duplicate in this case, since, and just try to match it with the design that was here before. You're gonna press Command X, take this one, double click this one, and then Command V, we have it right there. And then yeah, sometimes I do it with multiple pages, which is actually better to show more of your design. I do kind of like four pages in this case, but just to show you guys, it's just, I'm just gonna duplicate the same design and just show you how you do this. I'm gonna paste this one right here. I'm pressing Alt just to copy them. And yeah, it's as simple as this. And you know, just duplicate it as much as you can. And it's gonna help you guys. Making a lot of designs is gonna help you to get better at design, simply because you're just producing so much. You're just practicing every time you're making a design. It's gonna help you develop this technique to make you work faster, to help you break through when you have any type of problems of creative block. This helped me a lot. That's why I just like to design a lot all the time. And yeah, and it's gonna give us a design like this. One thing I like to do is to use one of the maybe the main colors of the design, just to change the color of the artboard right here. And let me just remove this. We have the color of the artboard right there. One thing I could try to do is simply, since I have already this background, we can use the different blending modes, maybe soft light, or maybe let's change it to multiply. I think that's gonna work again. Yeah, because it's gonna give us the darkest colors and it's gonna work really, really, really well. And after changing the overlay, this will bring us to the end of the video. If you feel like you learned something new, just give it a like. That'll help me a lot. Don't forget to download these templates and use them completely for free. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you again in the next video.